Dear students, today in this lecture I will discuss about the oxidative addition reactions. So I will prepare a series of lectures in oxidative addition reactions because it is a very lengthy chapter, and to understand each and every aspect of this oxidative addition reaction, we have to first understand the meaning of oxidative addition reaction. So in this lecture I will take about the oxidative addition reactions in general. What are oxidative addition reactions? Which type of reactants they participate in this kind of reaction? So I will discuss about only the general idea about the oxidation addition reactions in this lecture. And after this lecture I will give you the insight on the types of reagents and the mechanism of oxidative addition reactions, and the types of mechanism, and what are the different mechanism according to the types of reagents. So we will cover the whole unit under this lecture series. So I will start with oxidative addition reaction. So simply, if we think of oxidative and addition, so there are two terms, oxidative and addition. So oxidative means this reaction is going to be oxidation type, and addition means there is addition of something in the reactant. So two type of reactions, they join together and they form oxidative addition reaction. One is oxidation and other is addition. So due to involvement of these two words, this reaction becomes oxidative addition. So if we see the oxidative addition reactions, it can be divided into two types. It may be mononuclear, it may be binuclear. It may be mononuclear oxidative addition reaction or may be binuclear oxidative addition reaction. So if it is mononuclear oxidative addition, then it is also called as two electron oxidative addition. We will see with the help of example. I will explain you what do we mean by two electron oxidivity addition reaction. So I will give the examples of both the reactions. So in the binuclear oxidative addition reactions, it is also called as one electron oxidative addition reaction. And if we see this mononuclear oxidative addition reaction, it occurs via cis oxidative addition. It is also known as cis oxidative addition reactions because generally the reactants, they joined in the reagent on the reagent or the metal complex in cis manner. And this binuclear oxidative addition reactions, they generally occur through homolytic activation. As we know, homolytic means if we are adding H2, then due to homolytic fission, 2H will homolytically cleaved in H2, and 1H goes to 1M and the other H will go to the other M. You will see with the help of examples. So first we will see that what is going to change during these oxidative addition reactions. If A is converting into B through oxidative addition reactions, then three things will occur. These are the requirements of oxidative addition reactions. So when oxidative addition reaction takes place, oxidation state of this metal will increase. Electron count of this metal complex will increase, and then coordination number of this metal will increase. Oxidation state will increase because this is oxidation reaction. Then coordination number will increase because it is a addition type of reaction. Addition is taking place. So addition, due to addition of the reagent, coordination number of the central atom will increase. And as the coordination number will increase, because coordination of which? kind of substances that are ligands. So if the ligands bind, they are added to the central atom, then they will also increase the electron count, because one ligand can donate its electrons to the central atom. So during oxidative addition reactions, these are the three reactions, or the three these are the three conditions. Oxidation state of the metal atom will increase, electron count will also increase, and the coordination number will also increase. Now we will see the mononuclear or two electron type oxidative addition reaction. So this is the example of mononuclear two electron oxidative addition reaction. If this is the complex, this is a organometallic complex, and this is the reagent which is going to add into this metal complex. And if oxidative addition reaction is taking place, then this AB will add to this metal center. You can see that this AB will add to this metal center, and thus you can see that. But you can see that oxidation state of this metal will increase by 2. This is the addition of this AB type reagent on one metal center. So it is mononuclear. So AB is add to the one metal center, and the oxidation state of metal will increases by 2. Coordination number will increases by 2. You can see that here the coordination number is n, but here the coordination number is n plus 2. So coordination number increases, and then you will see this electron count will also increase by 2, as there is addition of two atoms A and B. These can donate one electron, and thus increases the electron count of M. So this is a kind of mononuclear, or we can say two electron oxidative addition reaction. Now this is the example of binuclear oxidative addition reaction, or it is also called as one electron oxidative addition reaction. And you can see that there are two metal centers. You can see 2LNM. So we are taking two metal centers, and addition of this kind of reagent AB, if we add this reagent to this, you can see that one atom will add to one metal center and the other will add to the other metal center. So we will get LNMA, LNMB. So you can see that it is binuclear type, because this addition is taking place to the two nuclei, with the two nuclei. So one electron will gain here, this metal atom will gain one electron, and this metal atom also gain one electron. So here the electron count will be one. In this kind of reactions, the electron count will one, because this is one atom which is giving its electron to this metal center. So the increase in electron count will be one. The coordination number change will also be 1, because one atom is added here and one atom is added here. So the total number in the coordination number is n plus 1. So it is increases by 1. So oxidation state will also increases by 1, because it is a binuclear type oxidative addition reaction. So I think you can understand the difference between one electron and two electron type of oxidative addition reactions, and we can say that there are mononuclear and binuclear oxidative addition reactions. In case of mononuclear, you can see that there is change of oxidation state, coordination number, and electron count by 2, while in case of binuclear oxidative addition reactions, the change is by plus 1. Change in oxidation state, the change in coordination number, and change in electron count, it takes place by a unit of 1. If you have noted that I have put the equilibrium sign in between oxidative reactants and products. So we can say that oxidative addition reactions, they are reverse of that of reductive elimination reactions. Theoretically it is possible oxidative addition reactions, the product can reversely react and they can form the initial reactants, or vice versa. It is the truth theoretically, but in practice it is not so. only one reaction at a time, either oxidative addition or reductive elimination. In practice, it is true that only one kind of reaction takes place at a time, maybe oxidation or maybe reductive elimination reaction, because this oxidative and reductive elimination reactions, they depends upon the overall thermodynamics. They depends upon the overall thermodynamics, means to the side where the delta G value, it becomes negative, the reaction will go that side, or the change in entropy should be positive. So it depends upon the overall thermodynamics of the reaction. Then this reaction, the direction of the reaction, it also depends upon the relative stabilities of two oxidation states. Which oxidation state is more stable, that affects the equilibrium, that the reaction occurs either towards oxidative side or towards the reductive side. And also the bond strength will affect the direction of the reaction. Old bond are strong or new bonds are strong, that will affect the direction of the reaction, that may be forward direction of oxidative addition reaction or maybe reverse, that is reductive elimination reaction. So both cannot occur simultaneously. Only one reaction can take place for one time. So, and that depends upon the overall thermodynamics, the relative stabilities of oxidation states and bond strength. We can see with the help of example. This is, if we see the example of alkyl halide. So alkyl halide plus metal complex, they can easily form an adduct. This is oxidative addition kind of reaction. This metal complex can bind alkyl halide and form an adduct. But this adduct cannot form or cannot dissociated into metal complex and alkyl halide. So we can say that this takes place only towards the forward direction. So this is the oxidative addition reaction. Its reverse is not possible because of some thermodynamic region. So this oxidative addition reaction and reverse, its reverse, that is reductive elimination reaction, they are very they depends upon the situation. What are the situations, and then they occur accordingly. So now we will discuss about some important points regarding oxidative addition reactions. So what will be the important points regarding oxidative addition reactions? I will teach you one by one. There are some points to be remembered about the oxidative addition reactions. So number one point is that third row transition elements gives more stable adducts. Number one point, third row elements gives more stable adducts. Actually, you will see maximum organometallic compounds of iridium, palladium, platinum, they are used for oxidative addition reactions due to stronger ML bonds, because they can form stronger ML bonds. So oxidative addition reactions, because there is addition of metal and ligands, so it is the requirement of oxidative addition reaction that ML bond should be strong, and ML bond will be strong with the third row transition elements. So generally the complexes suitable for oxidative addition reactions are from third row transition elements. Reaction in the oxidation direction favored by strong donor ligands. Why? It is a kind of oxidation reaction. The oxidation direction reaction is a kind of oxidation reaction. In oxidation reaction, the oxidation state will increase. Oxidation state will increase. So how oxidation state will increase? When the ligands, they easily donate their lone pair of electrons, thus they decrease the oxidation state of metal. They increase the oxidation state of metal. So if the ligands, they have good donor tendency, how? if this is metal and this is ligand. So if this ligand has better sigma donor ligand tendency, then if this ligand, this metal is at zero oxidation state, if this can give its lone pair of electron to metal, then it will increase its oxidation state. And in oxidative addition reactions, the oxidation state of a metal increases either by plus 1 or by 2. So for this, the strong donor ligands, they initiate or they catalyze the oxidative direction of the reactions. So oxidative addition reactions are favored by strong donor ligands. Now in the oxidative addition reaction, the breakage of AB bond, AB is the reagent, sigma bond, this is a kind of sigma bond, it occurs. Generally the breakage of AB bond occurs, and during this AB bond breakage, electron transfer from metal to sigma orbital. Actually there are two kind of electron transfer. One electron transfer I have already discussed, that is from ligand to metal. Ligand to metal, if the ligand donate its electrons to the metal, then its oxidation state will increase. So it is a kind of oxidation. Now the second step is breakage of AB bond occur, and during this breakage, the electrons from metal, they goes to the sigma star orbital of AB bond. Thus formation of two new bonds takes place. Why? Because electron transfer from metal to sigma star orbital of AB bond, it causes the breakage of AB bond and formation of new bonds. So in oxidative addition reactions, there is breakage of AB bond and then formation of new bonds, that are MA bonds and MB bonds. I can again show you the reaction in which you can recall about the formation and breakage of bonds. So this is the reaction. If you recall that this AB bond will break, and after this breakage, formation of two new bonds, MA and MB, it will take place. So how it will take place? This metal can donate its electron to the sigma star orbital of AB, and thus this bond will break. After breakage of this bond, these two ligands, they can donate their electrons to the metal. So thus there are occurring two things. One is breakage of AB by the transfer of electron from M to sigma star of AB, and second is the donation of electron from A and B to the metal, thus increasing its oxidation state. So this is, what is this? This is oxidative addition reaction. Now this, the other requirements for oxidative addition reaction is the metal should be electron rich. Metal should be electron rich so that low oxidation state favor oxidative addition reaction. As I have shown earlier that if the metal is in zero oxidation state, then it can easily convert into the higher oxidation state, so that oxidation will takes place. So zero means more electrons, two means less electrons. So metal should be rich in electrons, or you can say that metal should be in its lowest oxidation state so that its oxidation can easily takes place, and this will favor the oxidative addition reaction. So I can show you some examples of oxidative addition reactions. So these are the type of oxidative addition reactions. You can see that here, or this gold is in its one oxidation state. So it can easily, it is a lower oxidation state. So it is having D10 configuration. Higher, it is electron rich species, and it can convert into Au3. And this is the oxidation. So this is oxidative addition reaction, in which you can see that D10 is converting into D8. So this can easily undergo oxidative addition reaction, and this can undergo mononuclear kind of oxidative addition reaction. Likewise, this PT0, PD0, PT0, they good reagents for oxidative addition reactions because they are at their lower oxidation state, and that after addition of reagent they can convert into 2, and their oxidation easily takes place because they are electron rich species, and this also takes place through mononuclear mechanism. These are the other examples where you can see that RH, IR in first oxidation state, they are converting into third oxidation state, so that the D8 is converting into D6. So these are good for oxidative addition reactions because they are electron rich metals, and this also occurs through mononuclear oxidative addition reaction. Again, you can see that Re1. Then you can see cobalt second is converting into cobalt third. It is a binuclear type oxidative addition because there is a change of only one oxidation state. This means it is a binuclear oxidative addition reaction. So with the help of this oxidation state, we can also classify these kind of oxidative addition reactions into mononuclear, where the change in oxidation state is by 2. So this is mononuclear. But here only the change in oxidation state is by 1 unit. So it is binuclear type oxidative addition. Now the other point to be remembered is that oxidative addition reaction is not limited to transition metals. Sometimes it also occurs where the oxidation state of elements are 2 unit apart. Sometimes it also occurs in the case of P block elements, where the elements are far from each other, their oxidation state by 2 units. So we can see that in PCl3, P has 3 oxidation state as well as 5 oxidation state. So it can easily oxidatively add Cl2 and form PCl5. Likewise, the formation of Grignard reagent. So in this case, MeBr, this is methyl bromide, is reacts with Mg and can easily form methyl magnesium bromide, which is a Grignard reagent. So I think you can easily understand, or you understand the oxidative addition reactions. What is oxidative addition reaction? Kya hai ek oxidative addition reaction? So oxidative addition reaction, you can easily explain that oxidative means oxidation, addition means addition. So this oxidative addition is of 2 types. It may be mononuclear, it may be binuclear. Mononuclear means 2 electron and 2 electron oxidative addition, and binuclear means 1 electron oxidative addition. And we have already also discussed about some points regarding oxidative addition reaction, when the oxidative addition reactions takes place. So I can conclude that for oxidative addition reactions, the metal center should be electron rich. Number 1 point. Number 2 point is the ligand should be a good donor. Electron should be a good electron donor. Second point. Third point is the transition metal series, that is third transition metal series elements, they generally favors the oxidative addition reactions. Okay. So these are some important points regarding oxidative addition reactions. So in the next lecture, I will discuss about the types of reagents that can favor the oxidative addition reactions. So we can classify the different reagents for oxidative addition reactions. So thank you very much. I think you can understand now. You can understand the oxidative addition reactions in general. Then after going through this video, you will able to understand the whole story about oxidative addition reactions. So thank you very much.